message for President Snow. If we burn, you burn with us.
Slate.
Jamal Finkley with BLACKTREE TV, you have speed.
Natalie, I first caught up with you last year at the SAG Awards carpet with the rest of the cast of Game of Thrones, and everybody was such a shock about your hairdo and what was going on.
That was the day I revealed my hair.
Yes, yes, and then you could look at all the comments underneath, people just one way or the other about it. How did it feel to just do that physically for a character, to have to shave that hair and to rock it? Like, how did that connect you to the character in a different way?
Yeah, I mean, when you look in the mirror and your appearance has changed so dramatically, especially once the tattoo was added as well, it's kind of great. It gets you halfway into the character because, like, they're kind of there staring back at you.
Yeah.
And, you know, so, and then you add the heavy army boots and, like, the, you know, the combat fatigues, and it makes you move differently, and then your physical transformation is halfway there, so then you just got to do the mental stuff. But it's great.
Hunger Games always talks about so many issues that you can relate to what we're going through in real life, and propaganda, I feel like, maybe today, you know, more than ever, because there's so many different forms of media, it's just overwhelming today. You know, from playing that role where you was part of this propaganda machine for the rebellion, how do you look at propaganda, and does it ever serve like a good purpose and a bad purpose? Like,
it definitely serves a good purpose. Everything is subjective. The minute you point a camera in any direction, it becomes subjective. So it can be used for good and for bad. And you know, you only need to turn on your news channel, and you know, the way the news is covered is going to be slightly different in Paris to the way it is in London, to the way it is in DC, to New York. I mean, there's always an angle because we're humans. And so it's very, as you say, it's incredibly relevant to modern society that we are aware of that, not to always believe fully everything we see. There's always a hidden element to the story. This is my assistant, Masala.
It's an honor to meet you.
And your cameraman over there, Castor.
Hello.
And Pollux.
Let's get locked in.
You're all from the Capitol? Plutarch got you out?
Don't expect much chit-chat from him. Capitol cut his tongue out years ago. And no. It wasn't any sort of rescue, if that's what you mean. We all fled on our own. For this. For you.
You're directing in this. I mean, you're in the movie directing scenes for within the movie. And I know you've done, you know, the stage and you've done the big screen. Have you ever thought about getting behind the camera and directing your own film?
You know, it's one of those things that possibly I'll think about in the future. Not anytime soon. I have so much respect and love for directors. They're incredible creatures. And it was just nice to pay a little homage to, you know, people, camera crews, camera operators, and directors who work there, who are such a big part of my life. And it was fun to shout action on a set that's, you know, not actually mine. And Francis Lawrence was very good. He encouraged me to ad lib, to improvise a bit, so that I felt like I had control, that I could move the camera boys to the right or the left. I could stop Jen mid sentence, make her start again, to give me that little bit of autonomy to make it feel real.
Yeah.
And a lot of that made it into the movie, actually, which I was, you know, like, stoked and very happy to see that that had happened. So.
And lastly, we've seen you on so many big screen type of productions, whether it's Tudors or this movie or Captain America or Game of Thrones, but you've also went back to the stage with Neverwhere and After Miss Julie. Like, what's the dichotomy of being able to do these big productions and then go to the big stage and do theater? Like, as an actress, how do you balance those two gears?
Yeah, it's the best of all worlds, and it requires different skill sets. So I just want to keep doing all three mediums, television, stage, and cinema, because they all have slightly different demands of you, and they all challenge you in slightly different ways. And if I can just keep on doing all three, I'll be a very happy lady.
You keep on doing great performances. I'm sure you'll be in all three mediums and more. Thank you.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you.